Bruno Mars impersonator scams Texas woman out of 100K. Case has ties to Houston. You know the perpetrator's real names? Basil and Chinwindu. Yep, we're talking about the Valentine's Day scams. What's up, guys? Hope you're doing well. Welcome to the studio of the Internet Detective. I'm your host, Coffeezilla, and let me say welcome back. It is a beautiful day. We're talking about the Valentine's Day scams because with everything coming up, you gotta be warned. Okay, honestly, most of y'all aren't gonna fall for this, but it's incredible to me that people still do. And when they do, they fall for
a lot of money.
A 65-year-old woman in North Texas got scammed by a Bruno Mars impersonator. This one's hard for me. Normally, I am the most sympathetic towards victims. I understand the psychology of desperation, loneliness, feeling like you don't have another option. But this is another level. I mean, this might be getting to dreams of grandeur. I could have Ariana Grande in my DMs right now. I wouldn't believe it. I don't buy into any of this stuff. Let me be honest with you. Look, my wife, I didn't believe her for the first, 10 years or so we dated. She was walking down the aisle when finally I said, you know what? This may not be a catfish after all. I don't think you should trust anybody unless they show up. I think this poor lady, I do feel bad for her, lost 100K to these scammers. I think she should have said, hey, until you get into bed with me, Chin, I'm not going anywhere. I'm not giving you a dime. Why would you think Bruno Mars needs your money? 100K ain't even paying for a pinky ring. I don't know what the big idea here is, but let me just tell you guys about these two characters behind this whole thing. They're two guys identifying themselves as Bruno Mars, and they text you for a long time, then they eventually ask you for money. That's how romance scams work. But the two men associated in this particular scam were Basil and Chinwindu. Now, let me just say, okay, there's a lot of famous duos in history that you could have been proud of getting scammed by, almost. Like Bonnie and Clyde, for example. But you get scammed by Basil and Chinwindu, it's a bad look, okay? Chinwindu is not even the most famous Windu. His older brother, Mace, is. Okay, so I just think, look, you have to have a dose of skepticism by the time you're 65 years old, and you have to have a sense of realism. Bruno Mars doesn't care about you. Bruno Mars is not your friend. Bruno Mars is not gonna date you unless you have minimum 50 million followers. It's just not gonna happen for you. Or you're like a 12. You're not gonna be 65 years old and getting asked for money by Bruno Mars. Instead, of course, when you look behind the scenes, it's all Chinwindu. Why is that name so funny to me? Asking you for money. Please be careful, guys. You gotta vet these people. Love makes people do crazy things. So does money. But at the end of the day, you need a reality check. And if people around you are going to you saying, hey, it's probably not Bruno Mars in your DMs, they're probably right. That's the biggest thing you notice with people like this is their friends often reach out to them, tell them how crazy they're being, and they don't listen. And while I sympathize with the loneliness, you know, the desperation, you have to expect this to happen when you're dropping 90K. Apparently, the Bruno Mars man promised he was quitting tour to be with her. It's just sad. Don't be like this. Don't get robbed by Basil and Chinwindu, and I promise you'll do very well in your life. All the best from me. I love you guys, but not in that kind of way. Happy Valentine's Day early. Hopefully, I'm getting this out before that so I can warn everybody. And I will see you tomorrow.